It's Conduit News Radio with Paul Harrell.
Turn this up, press that button, and we should have Blake Johnson. Blake, are you there?
Yes, sir. How are you, Paul?
I'm doing good. Hey, I'm sorry about that. How was the prayer caucus?
It was good. I apologize. Yep. This is a little bit longer than normal.
Hey, so. You know what? You know, that's... I think everybody's been somewhere where a prayer is lasting just a little too long.
Absolutely.
If we're honest about it. Senator Blake Johnson, I wanted to have you on. I want to highlight this bill that you got. It is SB 620, School Choice Pilot Program. Tell me about it.
It's the Capital Promise Scholarship, and it'll help approximately 500 children in Pulaski County and their parents have a choice to attend a private school if they so choose, and if they feel like they're in a public setting that they don't fit. So and it's the governor's discretionary funds that he'll be using. It's not funds that would go to the public schools, and it's just the pilot, and it gives, they have to take a norm reference test, and it's they track their GPAs, and it'll if they have a 2.5 on graduation, if a student is in there, they can go to a Institute of Higher Education in Pulaski County with $5,000
wow.
scholarship. So this also from K through 8, grade to K through 8, gives 80% of the foundation funding, and from 9 through 12, it gives 100% of the foundation funding.
Wow.
And scholarship. So
that's awesome. This is a great first step. I think this is going to really, you know, because I've talked to some people that, you know, they believe in school choice, but they think the schools back home where they are, everything's going fine. But then you look at some of these, you know, lower socioeconomic situations, and you don't want kids to be confined just based on their zip code. I mean, and this is a step in the right direction. Now, this used to be something, Senator Blake Johnson, this used to be something school choice when it was first, when it was first thought up. This was something that got bipartisan support. Democrats and Republicans thought this was a good idea. Yet the Democrats 2 days ago have a big press conference in the old Supreme Court room, and they're saying that this is a terrible idea. So why do you think they're so opposed to this, Senator Johnson?
I don't understand it. They have touted it as racial in nature, and it has nothing to do with race at all. It has to do with socioeconomic. And given hope and opportunity to families and a choice that of their choosing, no matter what color, those folks need a choice.
So you think, so they're saying that this is somehow trying to punish black schools? Is that what they're saying?
Well, I didn't get to attend. I was had another meeting at the time, but that's the tone that I received in that.
Wow. Well, you know, it's just really sad because that's not at all. And, you know, we have this education system that, you know, it produces good results, but I think it's also producing bad results, or, you know. And so this is an idea to say, hey, let's try something new. I personally think, much like the states of Arkansas, or I'm sorry, the states of this country, they're supposed to be little laboratories of experimentation. Now, that rarely happens anymore. I mean, it still there are still a few instances of it. But, you know, the federal government kind of gets everybody into line by giving our own money back to us with strings attached. But, you know, here with these local school districts, I would love to see these local school districts be able to do these different ideas to mm-hmm. see if it works or not. And then maybe it catches on and it will spread. And I think the Democrats are afraid that this idea will spread to other counties.
Even in a succeeding school, a student can feel that it doesn't fit, and the parent and students should have a choice to transfer if he needs to be, even in a successful school and a productive school. And it's not just about failing schools or mm-hmm. or in a bad situations. It's, you know, the child may not fit, and this may allow the child to flourish in a different setting. So
yeah, so it's really about personal choice. It's about personal freedom. I mean, this is a freedom issue.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
Man, that's fantastic. We're talking with Senator Blake Johnson. He's a Republican from Corning. Let me ask you this. SB 620, when do you think you're going to run this bill out of the Senate Education Committee, I'm assuming?
They have a pretty extensive docket. I'm going to try to run it today if I can. So, okay. Because we're getting close to the end, I'll probably try to run it today.
Okay. And so they meet today, and I guess they're going to meet, what, like 10 o'clock this morning?
10 o'clock, yes.
Okay. Wow, that'll be interesting. I'm sorry. You know me. I mean, covering the news is my job, and covering controversial stuff is my job. It'll be very interesting to see what the people have to say who are signed up against this. Now, and that's why I wanted to have you on as well, because anytime you have this kind of reaction from the Democrats, from the left, you know, it can be hard to stand up to the pressure. Okay. And so that's why I think this is good. I'm very, very pleased. I think the people are pleased to hear that Governor Asa Hutchinson is supportive of this. And I know you got support in the Senate, and down at the House end, you got State Representative Ken Bragg. Now, how did this happen, Senator Johnson? I mean, how did you guys come up with this specific idea?
You know, we had, Ken and I had filed a bill that was, it was similar, but it was based on tax credits. And this is an idea that the governor had had over a period of time, is to try to make it a pilot program and to test the success. And this has a lot more measurable features in it that Department of Ed will be helping in. So, I mean, it's similar in nature, but it's a lot more trackable, and that way it can be measurable. So,
yeah, I think that's good. You know, and it's a small step. It's like, hey, one small step, you know, one small step in Pulaski County, but it could be the beginning of a lot more freedom for parents across the state of Arkansas. And man, I'm really, really excited that this is being run, because this is a key plank of the Republican platform, Blake.
Yes, sir. And I appreciate the opportunity to come and talk about it on your program today.
All righty. Well, hey, I think that's the committee I'm going to go to today, so maybe I'll see you there.
All right. Okay. Thank you, Paul. Have a good day.
Yes, sir. You too. That's Senator Blake Johnson, everybody. And again, that bill, SB 620, the School Choice Pilot Program for Pulaski County. Again, the bill would establish a new scholarship school choice program for students. Let's see here. In Pulaski County, $3.5 million would be set aside to fund the scholarships. Low-income students that qualify for free and reduced lunch would be eligible for the scholarships to be used at a private school. Up to 500 scholarships could be funded through the program. And this would, again, increase parents' choice for the best education for their child. There are no mandates, so no student has to participate. And the school choice long-term, of course, long-term increases economic freedom. Less dependence on government schooling, or less dependence on, you know, government edicts and mandates that, hey, you're born in this zip code, so you've got to shop at Walmart. You're born in this zip code, so you've got to shop at Kroger. You know, maybe you want the freedom to go send your child where you want to send your child, right? And that's if you're, you know, that's if you're down with the whole, public schooling system. All right, so we're going to take a break, going to reset here.